With all its features, D&D Beyond makes for an excellent resource for DMs and players alike, but it's often difficult to justify its use in conjunction with virtual tabletops when some will charge you again for the same content. Thankfully, that's not the case with Falgi VTT, because of amazing mod developers that have created clean ways of importing everything you own from D&D Beyond into Falgi VTT. Here's how to make it happen. And if you still need maps after all your importing, head over to the Mad Cartographer's Patreon, our continuing sponsor. They've got hundreds of maps to choose from, all with walling, lighting, and sounds built for use in Falgi VTT. Check out this month's theme of adventure maps on the Mad Cartographer's Patreon, link below. Now back to importing. The first thing you'll want to do is download the DDB Importer Chrome extension. If you don't use Chrome, I'd honestly recommend downloading it just for the extension, because it solves a ton of headaches later on. Once you've downloaded the zip file from the link in the description, unzip it. Then go to your Chrome Extensions page under More Tools and enable Developer Mode. Finally, hit the Load Unpacked button and select the unzipped folder. Now just go up to your extensions bar and pin it. This extension only copies a piece of info buried in your browser session and nothing more. Do not share this with anyone. Now you'll be heading into Foundry proper, where you can download the module. The developer also recommends downloading the magic items and skill customization modules, but those have not been updated for 0.8 and aren't really necessary for the vast majority of imported items anyway. Head into your game and activate the module. Then, in the module's core settings, paste your session key. You'll also need to copy your campaign URL if you get your D&D Beyond content via sharing from a friend. If you own it all yourself, you don't need to do this. With everything set up, we can start importing characters. These are done individually by creating a new actor and hitting the D&D Beyond button. Then copy in the URL of your character and select the things you want imported. Beyond that, there are tons and tons of options for fine-tuning the import, but for most everyone, you'll just want to hit Start Import. After a quick process, you'll see your character imported in all its glory. As you can see, all spells, items, and features have icons, as long as they come from official D&D Beyond content. Everything's ready for use in-game, with little to nothing that you'll need to manually change. This is great for the players, but what about importing all your DM content? For that, it's fairly easy. Just head into the Compendium tab and start up the DDB Muncher. Here you can bulk import all the content you own, from spells, items, monsters, and even whole adventure modules. It's as easy as just clicking the import button. This process usually takes a while, but you won't have to do it again until new content gets released. Once you've imported it, head into the DDB Compendium where you'll see the results. Since my friend owns all the books, every single spell, including Unearthed Arcana, is now in my Foundry game, all complete with beautiful icons. You can do the same with items, but when we get to monsters, you'll need to support their Patreon or go through their complicated process of setting up a proxy. I'd highly recommend supporting their work. The adventures are complicated to get imported, but it may be worth looking into if you run official settings. Despite all that, the incredible ease at which you can import the content you have on D&D Beyond makes setting up your games much easier. This is one of those modules that is a must-have for those making use of D&D Beyond. So, it's my birthday next week. My family is coming to visit, and I probably won't have time to produce another Foundry video for the week. But I have planned to release another D&D-based video earlier in the week, so stay tuned for that one. Shout out to all my continuing Shout Tier patrons, Chuck Stamos, Unix, Darkside, Shane, Modnar, Demetrius, Meowpenheimer, Nexus, and Smoothie Buns. I'll see you next time, and thanks for watching!